Another big show coming up tonight. We have a 400-game star and his coach joining us on the program, Nathan Curry, with all the latest news, stories and scores from across the state. Pickers and I continue to reveal two more players in our country team of the 2000s, and Ali Blackburn takes us back to that great city of Ballarat. Bulldogs taking on Port Adelaide a week away off the bench. Let's go. Yes, hello and welcome to Off The Bench, TAC, Safety Barriers Save Live, TAC Towards Zero. Great to have our partners on board. Great to have this man, the 97 best and fairest from the Cats, alongside of me. Pickers, welcome.
Oh, good to be here again, Swanner, and looking forward to another week of country football.
Yeah, a lot to get through tonight, as there always is. Let's have a look at your lay of the land for this week.
Well, I'm going back to old mate Rexy, big Rexy Hunt, and he called a big, big game on the weekend, and... Well, he's some sort of a big man, isn't he, Rex? It's good to see him back behind the microphone. Yep. Worked with him for a couple of years on radio. Mm-hmm. He's been lost to television, of course, but look at him. Doesn't lose anything from enthusiasm.
Oh, no. And that's a great thing for country footy that Rexy went back up there. It would have been a tough gig because players unseen, unsighted, and he's called the living daylights out of it.
Well, he did, but he would have done some prep. He's not bad at prepping when he really needs to. But well done to you, Rexy.
Yep.
Been doing it for about 40 years.
Absolutely. And called with Gus McLeod, who's a young boy up that way doing some good things.
Going places, Gus.
Absolutely, Gussie. So well done, and well done, Rexy. My lay of the land this week, Pickers, is a man that just trotted out for his 400th game, and that is Glenn Smith, or as they like to call him up that way.
Smitty.
Thank you very much. 400 games, so well done to Smitty. And we would like our viewers to get involved, Picks, with anything that they see that they think is worthy of the lay of the land moment.
Absolutely. Social, Facebook, Twitter, the like. We've got it on there. Just send us what you've got. If you've got a local hero we want to talk about, we'll do it next week on the show or the week after, in the coming weeks anyway, leading up to the finals.
That's it. Well, we thought with a man who just trotted out for his 400th game that it's probably worthy of getting him on the program. So, Glenn Smith, welcome to you. And more importantly, Glenn's also brought the coach, and that is Mark Carnes from the, Ballara Football Club, which is Ballara, which is in the mid-Gippsland League. Welcome, gents.
Thanks for having us.
400 games. Well done.
Games.
400 big ones, six best and fairest. You started when you were 19. How have the B&Fs been spread out?
Out all the way through.
When was your last one?
Last year.
You won the last year?
Yeah.
Now, I asked you off air, I think you took a bit of offence to this, that how old you actually are.
Yeah.
So, 39. 39. Much longer will you keep playing? 400 games, can you get to 500?
No chance.
Hey, Picks, don't worry about 500. They've got a character at that footy club who's knocked up 700 games. 72-year-old Peter Rennie.
Yep.
Tell us about him.
Oh, he's been around for a long time.
Around forever.
Yeah, so I think Moses was playing back then. He's been there.
Now, you're the coach, Mark. I hate to say this. Now, you don't distance yourself from the scorelines. Senior team, 0-14. Reserves team, which I think you're the coach of.
Correct.
2-12.
Mm. Yep.
What's gone wrong at Ballara this year?
It's actually improved a little bit, mate, to be honest. We're looking forward.
So, mid-Gippsland Footy League, who are the teams to beat and where are you guys at? And how hard is it to get a team together?
Week to week, it's pretty hard, to be honest, at the moment. The way culture is, society is in general. I don't think people sort of give it the time that it probably deserves, it, as they have over the years. It's sort of lost face, I think, a little bit.
Kids aren't afraid of moving around either.
Absolutely, and just getting them on the park, I think, is the main thing.
Mm.
It's been pretty difficult.
Here's the 400 game running out with, I'm assuming that's your daughter, Glenn?
Yes, my two daughters and my son.
Fresh haircut, by the looks of it.
400. Sharp.
For his number 11.
Did you get a couple of touches?
Legs 11.
Got a couple of touches.
Yep.
What position are you playing, Glenn?
Play midfield or forward, anywhere.
And was that a photo with your son, Lockie?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep.
How old's he?
He's 14.
Wet day down there.
Looks like they turned the weather on.
Did they get a win for your 400th?
No, we didn't.
Not 400th.
Yeah, but they. No, that's the seniors. Did you play in the seniors or the reserves?
No, played the reserves.
Yeah. Don't worry about the seniors, mate. We're on the reserves. Well, they've won a couple
of
games.
We're going to like them both. Now, you're a farmer. I asked Glenn before. I said, geez, dairy farmer, you'd be up nice and early. He said, half six?
Yeah, well, half the day's done.
They go to work in Melbourne at half six.
Yep, up bright and early.
That's not that early. I was thinking you were going to say 4 a.m. Tell us about your farm.
We've got two farms that we milk cows on, so...
How many head?
300.
solid day's work, Pix.
Well, it sounds to me like he's got someone doing all the work because he's sleeping until 6:30.
I'd have the kids.
Yeah, someone starts milking the cows about 6. Is that right?
Yep, I do have a good worker.
I tip this.
Hey, tell us about Ray Wilson. He's another one of your long-serving contributors over years.
Yeah, keeps ticking along as well. He's doing the running at the moment, so he...
How old is he?
62.
How many games?
A few. Yeah, he's played a few as well. Sure. Not really sure how many, but...
So is a few more than 400?
Yeah, pretty sure.
So you've just started your career, effectively.
He's like
400 games.
He's like an apprentice.
Yeah. And who you got this weekend?
Moving north.
Chance?
Arch rivals.
Like to think so.
Really?
Always.
Absolutely. Yeah.
What's the biggest loss this year in the ones?
120 points, is it? Yeah. No, it was 140.
Have you got close to doing a couple of games?
They have been close.
Yeah.
Yep. Been in around there, but
competitive, but no cigar. Real Carlton sort of stuff.
Can't get over the line.
No, they have improved a lot over the last season anyway.
And do you enjoy the coaching side of it, Mark?
Yeah, it's my second crack actually. I've had 3 years off, coached for 4 years before that, and then got back into it this year.
What's his tactics like?
Technically
good.
Yep, they're right.
Sound. Yep. Sound. Oh, motivator.
Sound. He's always very motivated.
Smart move, Pitch, to bring the coach onto the program.
So you want to keep playing it,
is. Absolutely. Hey, boys, we appreciate you coming in. Congratulations on 400 games.
Yeah, well done.
Thank you.
And we wish you well this weekend. And for the rest of the year, let's hope that the seniors and reserves get a couple of wins under their belt before the season's finished. As a small token of our appreciation, you're going to take one of those away. Dometic Icebox worth $239. They'll keep the cans cold.
Oh, soft drink, they will.
Of course.
Yeah.
So well done, boys. We appreciate you coming in. We're going to take a break. When we come back, well, he's active on social media. Let's hope he's got something worthwhile sharing with us tonight. That is Nathan Curry with all the latest news stories and scores from across the state. Off the bench, thanks to the TAC. Safety barrier save lives towards zero. Yes, welcome back to Off the Bench. All thanks to the TAC Safety Barriers Save Lives, TAC Towards Zero. Time now to welcome back Nathan Curry. Welcome, Nate.
Thank you, boys. Good evening.
You've got a very sharp new head. You've got rolling there, I've noticed.
Thank you very much, Piggers. I'm up and about. I'm going to Hawaii next week.
I beg your pardon.
I'm going to Hawaii next week, so this will probably be my last show because I'm not expecting for you boys to ask me back.
Yeah. Well, it is borderline.
You're going to Hawaii 4 weeks into a program.
He's going to Hawaii, but things have been a little bit barren on the home front.
Oh, really?
You're single at the moment?
Not at the moment. I am single at the moment, but I've had a bit of luck. I've joined Bumble, if you know what that is. It's a dating app.
Pardon?
Bumble, a dating app.
It's
very classy. I've had a bit of luck.
He's given up.
Put him in the stable and straighten him up.
He's given up.
I'm doing well. I've been on 3 dates. I was rolling with a photo of the three of us, but wasn't having much luck. So if you take a look at the screens, I had to make a few adjustments, and things have gone a lot better since I just cropped one Liam Pickering.
I'm not on Bumble.
I've had it much better luck. You're ruining the photo pickers, but no one was giving me anything. Cropped you out and all of a sudden I've been on 3 dates. So
that's why I kept getting messages from random people.
Really?
Hey,
he's trying to use our profile to get himself a date.
Hey, let's run a comp. Well, Nathan's away and you'd like to go out on a date, your entries in via our social media handles and we will self-select who we think is an appropriate person to go out and look after you.
That's what he's doing. He's doing that now for a bit of off the bench sort of fan engagement. Right, let's get to the footy.
Let's jump into our GRV footy roundup. That's all thanks to Victorian Greyhound Racing. Love the dogs, love the thrills. You're already on holiday, I can see.
I haven't mentally checked out yet. This is your old league, Swan of the Hampton Footy League. Massive upset.
Benny Cunnington.
Here. Cobden getting over the line against Terang Mortlake, which is a huge blow to the Bloods finals chances. They now have got a record of 5-7, and they are in real danger of missing the top five. Great 24-point win.
Oh, go the Roosters.
Yeah, if you have a look there. And Warrnambool is the one to keep an eye out. They've really got their season back on track. They upset Pickers favourite team, Port Ferry.
Can anyone beat Koroit?
The Ferries
can. Anybody beat Koroit later this year?
Oh, I think they've got it in the bag. Five in a row, I think.
No way.
Far too
strong
good.
Team.
No, the Ferries, I reckon, for mine.
All right, Ovens and Murray.
Yeah, this is Albury v North Albury, the Albury derby. And as we saw earlier, Rex Hunt was calling this one. I think the fat lady would have been singing pretty early. Though Albury kept North Albury scoreless until the 20-minute mark of the second term, and it was a 125-point win.
Why are they playing with a white football?
The O&M's very strong on white ribbon round. Yeah, they're doing their bit to stamp out violence against women, which was, really good. They're huge on that up there.
Yeah, look at Johnny Longmire's old mob.
Where?
Ninth.
Oh, really? No
out
good.
Out of 10. And remember
Wangaratta Road? Is that Robbie Walker? What a player he was.
Star up there. He played with us at North.
All right, what about the Gippsland League?
Yeah, big win for Traralgon here. They got some revenge against Juan Thaggy. The Power touched them up earlier in the season, but the Maroons got a 39-point win over here, which is really great. So they lost the prelim last year. They're currently in fifth spot, and they really needed to win this one to keep their chances alive. And if we have a look at the ladder, they're playing Warragul next week, so that's 5v6. So, yeah, that's a huge game.
I'm still liking the Paris there, Lee and Gather, who are equal top.
Is Bo Vernon still coaching Lee and Gather?
I think he is, yeah.
Well done.
I think Bo still is,
great fan 1 and 2 again, Maffa and Lee and Gather to play off again, I think.
North Ballarat v East Point.
Yeah, this one's big as well for East Point. They've never won a flag since East Ballarat and Golden Point merged in 2001, but they're now game clear on top after getting the job done against City, which is massive for them. A point down at three-quarter time and then, had a huge last quarter. And
This is Aston BB.
Yeah, similar. He hadn't won much and then last year won his elusive Melbourne...
Hadn't won for 47 starts.
Yeah, I was putting it lightly. So he won the Melbourne Cup last year and then quickly turned his form around, had three group three race wins and then, went out to stud last month with $800,000 in prize money.
Happy days. It's Ballarat Footy League.
East on top. I see the wind.
The Marsh.
The Lakers have got themselves in a bit of a spot of bother in fifth.
Sunbury.
And it's four of the top six are playing each other this weekend, so it's going to have a huge say on how the rest of the fixture goes.
Let's have a look at the Wimmera Football League.
Look at the Warriors. Look at Stall.
Where's Stall?
Who do you hate there, Pickers?
Ararat. Horsham. Horsham and Ararat are the two, our rivals, really. We don't worry about the rest of them, they weren't much good, but...
You were belting Johnny Longmire's team. Your team's not going too well either, Picks.
At least we've won four games.
Yeah, all Longs' team has won three.
They won two.
Okay, well, two.
Coral Brother Glenn.
Very good. The GRV Country Footy Wrap, all thanks to Greyhound Racing Victoria. Love the dogs, love the thrills.
And Bumble.
We love Bumble.
I can't believe you're on a dating app at your age.
Your applications in if you'd like to go out on a date with Nathan Curry in his absence. We'll make the announcement when he comes back, if we choose. For you to come back, by the way. Time now for McClarty McShane. We've got your back. Yep, McClarty McShane, specialists in general insurance, life and wealth, mortgage and finance. We've got your back. Elmore Footy Club and Netball Club Picks.
It is in the Heathcote District Football League. Winless. I'm trying to give them a little bit of support. Look at the percentage of the senior team. Mm. That's shocking, 34%. Look at the reserves percentage.
It's been a tough year.
Oh, it's been a tough year.
They're playing LBU this weekend too, so I don't think they're going to get a win.
I think they haven't kicked a goal to reserve since 2015.
Now, that makes it hard to get a lot of percentage, I have noticed that.
Oh, 23rd of June.
Cut him some slack, Spider.
It's on the bottom of that board.
You need to put...
It's a tough leg, the Heathcote District League.
Put your silly blue gloves on.
I know. Hey, in $500, we'll go to the Elmore Football and Netball Club. They need a little bit of a pep up. Absolutely.
Yeah. There you go. This is last week's result. They got a pump. Oh, they got pants, didn't they, really, by White Hills. They did kick eight. Did they kick eight big ones?
I can't see.
8-7.
There you go. That's where the local country offices for McClarty McShane are. Albury, Bendigo, Horsham, Kerrang, Rosebud, South Gippy, Shepparton and Swan Hill. Thank you to McClarty McShane. $500 going to the Elmore Football Club. Well, Bumble.
He's new hairdo. Safe
travels. Thank you.
Do you have to travel with an adult, considering you're a minor?
You are going with
sit on someone's lap, don't have to pay for a ticket, it's great.
You're going with your family, though, aren't you?
Yeah, going with the fam, meeting them over there on my housemate as well.
So. You know we love you, but if there's a photo of you in Speedos...
Oh, that's it.
You're not back. That's the only stipulation we're putting on you.
I'm pretty sure there'll be a photo of me shirtless.
Shirtless is okay, but they've got to be boardies. If they're speedos, it's done.
He's got a rig like Mr. Burns.
Hey, safe travels, have a good break, and we'll see you when you get back.
Thank you, boys.
We've got to take a break. When we come back, I think we're going to reveal two more players in our country team of the 2000s, and they're both from the same club. Off the bench, back with more after this. TAC, safety barriers save lives, towards zero. Welcome Welcome back to Off the Bench. TAC safety barriers save lives towards zero. Great to have our premium partners on board again. Picks, it's been a tough gig. We're going to reveal two more players in our country team of the 2000s.
We are indeed, Swatter. And I will say, you ask and you will receive.
Okay, what I'd like, we've got...
Let's get our team up for a start.
Absolutely. We've got some guns.
Currently roll with. We've got some very good players in
there. Guns. But you know what strikes me about this group?
These two spots we're going to
fill. Yeah, you know what strikes me about the name so far?
Yeah, what?
Great players.
Yep.
Rough heads. Pardon the pun.
Yeah, no, there's some...
I'd like a well-built, good-looking, manscaping, dashing, high-marking defender.
Which doesn't really make a lot of sense considering I'm now trying to put someone in the back pocket, but I found the guy, a real
Who have you got?
A real manscaper. He was a captain of the Bulldogs premiership team. He's a Camperdown boy.
I love him.
And he is an absolute gem. But he does fill that category.
Very good looking Easton Wood. He's a fine looking AFL specimen. And a good footballer too.
Very, very good footballer. Terrific in that premiership in 2016 for the Bulldogs.
Yep.
And has had a lot of injuries throughout his career. Only 125 games, an All-Australian as well. Now, halfback flank, what are you looking for?
I've always gravitated guys that were different picks, guys that walked to the beat of their own drum, a guy that might pack his family up in a combi and go to sort of a community or communal area.
Okie dokes, what about a 300-odd game player?
Not sure that came out the right way, but anyway, push on.
From the same club, on the other halfback flank with Hodgson.
Oh, none better.
Is Bobby Murphy, who, what a start Bob was, 312 games, two-time All-Australian, the Dogs captain, of course.
Hey, and a very good media performer too, by the way, in retirement.
Worked with him a bit on our radio platforms. He's very, very good and a good bloke to go with.
He's a ripper.
Just a bit unlucky he didn't get to play on that day, but he took over anyway.
Yep.
You might as well have been the best player on the ground. He was up there. He knocked the coach out of the way to hold up the cup.
Now, well done to Easton Wood and well done to Bobby Murphy. We'll continue to reveal more players' names and we'll reveal the whole team by the end of the home and away season.
I tell you what, it is a very good team, Swatter.
Oh, yeah.
It's building into a beautiful team.
There is a few blokes that are not going to be happy once the full team's been revealed, but if you've got an issue, then contact Pickers. Hey, from the retired and currently playing Easton Wood, Bob Murphy, let's have a look at a young man who's doing some very good things in the TAC Cup competition, and that is Caleb Sarong. Won't get drafted this year, Picks.
No, he's old. He's just missed the draft. He's a bit old. A bit young, sorry, for the draft this year. But
type of player?
Underage, inside mid. Very, very nice player. And plays for the Gippsland Power. Caleb Sarong, and he's one to keep an eye on. He'll be in next year's draft, so not quite eligible yet. Mm. Only missed out by a matter of days. Mm. He's a January birthday, I think, for memory. So he'll be next year's draft, so he'll turn 18 at the end of next year.
Well done to Caleb. We wish you well for the remainder of the season and next year as you work your way to possibly being drafted. Let's tell you what, Ballarat is a town that has really embraced the AFL feel. Pickers to the point where now they've rebranded their own stadium, Mars Stadium. Ali Blackburn, a premiership-winning women's player, takes us back to Ballarat. We're a week away from the Bulldogs hosting Port Adelaide. Ali, over to you.
While history remains among Ballarat's strongest draw card, the regional city now has AFL as a string to its bow.
The city is now as rich in wine as it once was in gold. So for a couple of rounds of refreshing beverages after the footy, don't go past this place.
For wine lovers, Converted Car Workshop and wine mecca Mitchell Harris is your answer to heaven.
And where there's wine, there's cheese. Time to check out the vibe with the local footy crowd in town.
What's the best thing about footy coming to Ballarat?
The trip away. It is a trip away for me. And it's character building, just hoping.
Oh, I think it's fantastic. I mean, I'm a bit old in the tooth, and I remember suburban football and six matches on a Saturday and going out to the Western Oval. So it's great to see football making a comeback to smaller local grounds, being transplanted back to where the grassroots are. Yeah, I think it's great.
We were just saying today how fantastic it is to park the car and to walk in our hometown to come to the footy. It's fantastic. It's great for Ballarat.
And who do you think is going to play well today?
Bulldogs.
That's Bulldogs.
We decided that football will be the winner today. I'm confident though. Doggies.
Oh, they're a passionate bunch up in Ballarat. The Bulldogs will next week head up there, play at Mars Stadium, take on Port Adelaide. Love the way that Ballarat and the greater community of Ballarat really got behind the Bulldogs and AFL footy up there, Picks.
Yeah, I've done both the games that have been there so far, and terrific experience. Magnificent ground. The boys have done a wonderful job getting the ground to the standard it is, but also good atmosphere when you're there.
And absolutely, well done to Ellie Blackburn, a fine footballer in her own right, and we really appreciate her going up to Ballarat multiple times and just giving us some colour and also showing the passion that people have for the Bulldogs and AFL footy in Ballarat. We're going to take a break. When we come back, I might get Pegasus tips for some AFL games. Great country clashes. Back with more after this, thanks to the TAC. Safety barriers save lives towards zero. Welcome back to the program. Thanks to the TAC, safety barriers save lives towards zero. Picks, time now to turn our attention to great country clashes.
Yeah, it is, Swanner, and we go to the Goulburn Valley Football League, and the all-conquering Kai Abram are on top of playing the closest challenger anyway in Benalla, who set second. They smacked them last time by 57 points. Kane Pettifer's team, nearly on the winningest streak of all time in country football.
Who's your tip?
They haven't lost for a couple of years. I'm going with Kai again.
Right.
It's at their home ground at Recreation Reserve on Saturday, so I think Kai Abram will win. I'd like to see Benalla get nice and close, but last time, well, the second team you played at once and they beat you by 10 goals, you're probably pushing it uphill a little bit, but... Anyway.
Hey, Stall, take on Horsham Saints. Stall footy club needs a win.
Yeah, four wins for the year is not good enough, Stall. So we need to sharpen up this week. And I think they will win.
Right, you do.
Horsham Saints have just got that ability to really fall in a hole when we put the pressure on it, Stall. And that's how it was back when I was playing 30 years ago. Long time ago. What about South Waterloo? Who do you take on?
Portland.
How long have they been in the Handy League?
Not long. And after this weekend, they probably want to go back to the old league, but I think the Roosters will win and we'll just stay in the top four. Thank you very much.
What sort of weather will you dish up in Warrnambool?
Windy, a little bit of rain, sideways wind, and around the Friendly Society Park where there's a bike track.
Exactly right. Hey, what about your other mob, the Swans? Got the Gold Coast, they should win.
Win, and a good win against the Kangaroos in the Brett Allison Cup last week.
In the what?
Brett Allison Cup, played for both teams. Some big games this weekend in the AFL too, by the way.
Cats worried.
Collingwood v North Melbourne.
It's a big game. I think North Melbourne might beat Collingwood.
Well, they have to win if they want to stay in contention for the top eight. What about the Cats? Your old mob against Melbourne down at the Cattery.
I am a little bit concerned about
this. Are you off the Cats?
I'm not off them, but
I'm sensing you're off them.
I'm concerned about our ruck battles, our ruck stocks versus Max
Thorne. Stanley's the strongest man in the gym.
Don't give me the strongest man in the gym garbage. Just get me a few kicks off, mate.
Hey, in the final one, which has consequences for the top eight, Port Adelaide taking on the Giants, and that is at Port Adelaide Sunday Twilight.
Yeah, look, I think the game being in Adelaide, I think I'll go with Port, but gee, they'll need to bounce back after letting themselves down against Fremantle the
Absolutely.
Other day.
Well done, Picks.
We'll
thanks to Smithy and Mark for coming on. Nathan Curry, have a great weekend. Good luck to netball and football teams across the state. We'll be back without Nathan Curry next week. See ya.